Committee. My name is Wendell Griffin. I am pastor of New Millennium Church in Little Rock, Arkansas. I am also a member of the board of directors of the Arkansas Unified Alliance, and I am here speaking in both capacities. I am also a person who was born September 23, 1952, which gives me the date to have lived firsthand under Jim Crow. And I know from personal experience that Jim Crow was relied upon under his own age. I can quote you chapters and verses. I also know that to say indirectly would lie directly in the hands of those who say, this bill indirectly burdens my ability to discriminate on the basis of race, sex, religion, or non-religion. Our congregation shares a campus with another congregation that hosts a substance abuse group. Read our stories. This bill would require both congregations to get a lawyer if anybody in the neighborhood says the hosting of this substance abuse group indirectly burdens our religion because we believe that we have a religious right not to have substance abuse and anything. I am a United States Army veteran. This bill would allow a devout Quaker who is a pacifist to claim that serving me indirectly burdens the exercise of their religion. Whether I buy a hamburger or go to a meeting, I want to live in the neighborhood, I want a job. I say all these experiences because from Jim Crow experiences, those were the very grounds by which I was created. And so I would agree with Representative Bonhoeffer. This is nothing new. This is very old. It is older than I am. It's older than my parents were. It's older than my grandparents were. It is 1896 old. Plessy v. Ferguson. And it is rigged. And for that reason, I'm asking you to please. Please, not passage. I invoke this reference. I prefer the reference to Dietrich Bonhoeffer. I, as a residential theologian in the congregation, am more than passive of leader than Dietrich Bonhoeffer. As a matter of fact, one of the leading scholars on Bonhoeffer in the country in our congregation, he's written a leading book on Bonhoeffer and the reasons why he went back to Germany. Part of which is because that he's been at the same church that he's doing the engine, not the engine. Dietrich Bonhoeffer was put to death by the Nazis, not because of his religion. Because this religion was a danger to the religion of the Bible. And the question here is, whose religion will be favored by this law? We have a system that is freedom, not only our religion, but also freedom from religion. This bill violates people. Please, do not take us back down this dark path.